Layers of history lie behind these walls at Tanner Medical Center in Carrollton, Georgia. Today it's a thriving hospital with room for 181 beds. But there was a time when this old house called the Carrollton Clinic was the only place for people to receive care.
They regularly had to clear the waiting room because somebody would come in with an emergency. Babies were typically delivered in the basement under 300-watt bulbs that would sometimes burn out during surgery.
The push was on to build something new, and a prominent physician helped lead those efforts.
Delivering as many as 7 babies in one day, all in separate homes.
Annette McClure Woods says her great uncle, Dr. Samuel D. Thomas, was well known, respected, and given full privileges in Carrollton during a time when segregation in other areas of Georgia was still intact.
In Atlanta, I understand, the black physicians had not been allowed to be in the white medical community.
Forging a new path, Dr. Thomas turned to the black community to help raise money for the new hospital.
It was understood at the time, Dr. Thomas and some other leaders encouraged people to understand that germs don't recognize color and that we needed a facility that really would provide care to every member of the community.
Years of fundraising efforts paid off. They broke ground, and in 1949, what was then called Tanner Memorial Hospital opened its doors. Dr. Thomas became the first African-American physician on the original medical staff, and his memory lives on in the hearts and minds of his admirers.
If you were running a fever, if you were having a baby, if you were having a heart attack, if you needed surgery, he was the guy you called.
He was given the right and privilege to care for anyone of any race, and that's why I love my hometown. That's why I love Tanner, and I'll always be grateful.